Thank you very much. And thank you very much for this invitation. Dear friends, distinguished guests, it's a great pleasure for me to welcome you in Bucharest, and I want to thank you for your presence at this conference taking place in a very important moment for Romania, the presidency of Council of the European Union. European governments have a long tradition of implementing digital tools to assist them in offering government services to their citizens and they carry out the act of governing. Parliament and the Commission are looking with interest on this technology. They are looking for a way to develop them in order to improve the quality of the act of governing. One of the most important innovations that is now available when we talk about gathering and processing data is the distributed ledger technology, DLT. DLT is a good example of how a technology can help reduce bureaucracy, ensure a higher level of confidence in privacy of data, and improve efficiency in operation. DLT can solve such issues by reducing cost, assuring an increased security of data, and reduce the time needed for the process and access to more granular information. DLT enable recording of interaction and offer the transfer of value without a need for a central coordinating entity. When we say value, we can think to any record of ownership of an asset example, money security, land titles, but also ownership of specific information like identity, health information, and personal data. The potential of DLT for public sector services management is very high since this technology can help reduce bureaucracy and the administrative burdens for citizens, business, and public administration. There are a wide variety of possible situations where it can be implemented, such as the digitalization of decentralization of public registers, land, registry, licensing, citizen certification, and migration management. Furthermore, it can also be used by public authorities monitoring and regulating various types of market. For example, in October 2018, the European Parliament formed a resolution titled Distributed Ledger Technology and Blockchain, Building Trust with Disintermediation. The resolution states that DLT could potentially affect all sectors of the economy, but its focus of several important spheres: finance, healthcare, transport, education, copyright, public governance, data protection, and some others. Another field where we'll mention DLT can be used is the creative industry, where it can enable the tracking and management of intellectual property and facilitate copyright and patent protection. This can bring a lot of benefits, especially for authors, by ensuring a higher degree of transparency and traceability for their creation, and in the same time, reducing the need for the many intermediaries when we talk to receive payment for their work. DLT is very, very important. And when we talk about DLT, we have to keep in mind that is a technology which have its origin in the blockchain, the technology that sustains the emergency of the Bitcoin. So naturally, the financial sector is one of the sectors that has experimented with this technology the most. One of the main advantages of implementing DLT in the financial sector is the fact that it can improve transparency, help reduce transaction cost and heighten cost by allowing a better management of data and streamlining process. There is a lot of potential for this technology in all financial sectors, such as insurance and capital market. If we look at stock exchange, we can spot many areas where DLT can bring improvements. For example, the current setup of the stock exchange involves the use of the centralized database, the use of the intermediaries. It can be used for clinic and settlement process, is post-trade, it can be used for streamline the document flow and reduce the paperwork and even to reduce the involvement of intermediaries with the use of smart contract, thus reducing the riskiness associated with transactions. Besides the capital market, there is a bright future for the DLT in insurance business. For example, DLT can be used to reduce the cost and increase the effectiveness regulation for insurers, such as know your customer and anti-money laundering. Thus, time spent on administrative work can be reduced. The client will not have to be checked by all parties involved in the insurance of an insurance. He can simply hold a certified key, which can be validated anytime it's used by the insurance company and intermediaries. An example of a counterparty of a country for this thing, was quick to adopt DLT and to implement it is Poland. The Central Security Depository of Poland implemented it, an e-voting solution which ensures a greater transparency regarding the history of their annual general meeting and the voting result, while in the same time it encourages greater participation, especially on part of the retail shareholders. Another example with regard to DLT implementation is Poland, is the Bank PKO, Bank Polski, which is using DLT to ensure compliance with European law by organizing by bank communication with its clients, is a repository based on DLT. Let's not forget the example of Estonia, one of the most developed and active countries, on its come to implementing new IT technologies in the benefits of its population. Estonia has implemented a digital project as country, level which reached its peaks in 2014 with the introduction of the air residency program. This means that anyone around the world, anyone, can apply to become an air resident in Estonia, which allows him to get access to all the online public services available to Estonian citizen. Last but not least, we have the example of the Central Bank of the Republic of the Azerbaijan. The Central Bank, in partnership with IBM, is developing a digital identification system based on DLT, which can be used by both individuals and legal entities. The solution is used to verify the reliability of the document when individual or legal entity turn to banks, credit providers, and other organizations. To sum up, we see that new technologies such as DLT can have a great impact on the way government or public services are being delivered for the citizen. Thank you very much for your attention.